Well, with the discussions were centered around the Ebola outbreak that is now ravaging the West African countries of Guinea, Liberia, and Sierra Leone. For us in Sierra Leone, we are talking about over 2,000 persons that have been affected, over 500 that have died, and over 400 that have survived. Interestingly, Sierra Leone has a high survival rate of about 22% compared to previous cases like Democratic Republic of Congo, where it started in 1976, where casualties were up to 90%. So we were discussing about what the FAO can do to help Sierra Leone fight the Ebola. In the area of agricultural sector, we have to note that the majority of the people affected by the Ebola are farmers, because two-thirds of the people of Sierra Leone are farmers. And interestingly, half of the population of Sierra Leone is poor, meaning that the majority of the poor people are the farmers, and they are the ones that bear the brunt of the Ebola. So we're talking about what can we do during the Ebola period to help these farmers. There is already a UN emergency appeal to support the agricultural sector, particularly the farmers, during the period of the Ebola. But thereafter, we also discussed about the possibility of undertaking a joint assessment of the impact of the Ebola on Sierra Leone, and that will happen also in the other countries, and thereby developing an emergency recovery program for agriculture, a post-Ebola recovery program for agriculture. Beyond that, before now, we had developed a successor program to the Smallholder Commercialization Program, which is a program that started, the government flagship program in agriculture started 2010 and will end this year. We had hired consultancy that produced a report to give an assessment of that program, and now to develop a successor program for the next 5 years. So that has been done by the consultant. They have produced the report and they have produced a proposed program. We want FAO to assist us to go through that program and to finalize it. These are some of the discussions that we held. But beyond that, I've also reminded the DG that my president had extended an invitation to him to visit Sierra Leone. In this critical time, we think that this is the time we know our friends in the time of crisis. A friend in need is a friend indeed. These are some of the issues we discussed. And we hope, he promised that by early next year, he'll be there in Sierra Leone. Well, the situation is such that we now have the Ebola started in one district called Kailahun in the late May, and that was the peak of the farming, the labor season for agriculture. That's the time in Sierra Leone we depend very much on family farming and group work. You know, a number of people coming together to do the farm work. Now, when you know the nature of Ebola, which is transmitted from person to person as it is in West Africa, that becomes very dangerous during that time for farming to go on, which means that it caused really farms to be abandoned. It killed a lot of people. Certain families have been wiped off. Villages have been decimated. Some villages have been deserted, and which means it will have an impact on agricultural production since farms have been abandoned and so forth. So that situation is not auguring well for us. Now, beyond that, the two districts that this Ebola affected most seriously in the country are the source of the major agricultural export produce for Sierra Leone, that is cocoa. Once these two districts are affected, that's bound to affect our main agricultural export. Beyond that, the Ebola has moved to other districts to the extent that last week, the government decided to extend the districts quarantined. Before, we only quarantined Kailahun and Kenema, which are the main districts that the Ebola is affecting. We have extended that to three other districts out of the 14 districts in the country. And these other districts, the three, are the food-producing districts. They produce more food. So in addition to a negative impact on export produce, this is bound to also affect food production and therefore food security in Sierra Leone. Well, we have mixed feelings. The response has been very sluggish to some points. I mean, I recall my president expressing disquiet about that. The response has been very sluggish. The magnitude has not been that adequate. But now we see a lot coming in. And must say that the Chinese have been very, very responsive. They have given a lot of support, not only once, and not only in material terms, but even cash and personnel. Just last week, the president launched 2 mobile labs to do the tests for Ebola. And they have also come with an army of medical personnel to assist us. They are manning some of the centers to do the treatment as well as the testing. So the Chinese have done very well. I must, of course, say that there are other countries that have tried, like America and England. They have also done their best. Well, I mean, I think I've said it all, that during the Ebola, specifically the UN special appeal, emergency appeal, FAO has to come forward very strongly because, as I said, the people that are most affected are farmers. You don't have to wait until Ebola goes. We don't know when. And secondly, the post-Ebola, to do the assessment of the impact, to develop a national agricultural recovery program, and then thirdly, to assist us review and finalize our next 5-year program, 2015 to 2018.